It's not that we just magically wait for the 2050s to show up. You need to be thinking about what needs to be true by 2040. You need to be thinking about what needs to be true by 2030. And since it's just a few months from 2025, we got to get going.
I come to iGEM for the tingles, to be inspired.
Where can I learn more about this field? The very first thing I say is come here. You want to see the future, you need to come to iGEM.
I think the future is very bright.
And I think it looks really bright in a large part due to iGEM.
It's giving a lot of people their first opportunity in a deep tech field, their first opportunity in biotechnology.
iGEM is the starting point of your career in synthetic biology for just about everybody these days.
So the fact that a 2018 iGEM project could literally save billions of lives, that's the power of iGEM.
The villages are an holistic effort to tackle global issues. They are a hub for collaboration and innovation.
If we want our grandchildren to have a life that we would be happy with, we need to do this now. And it's the people here who are going to make that difference.
One thing that's extraordinary about iGEM, it's not just working on the frontiers of science and technology, it's not just working on the policy for education and learning, it's all of this. And frankly, I know of no other venue where that can happen. It's iGEM.
One idea can change the world. The question is, what kind of world do we want to build together?
iGEM is on the forefront of incorporating responsibility in synbio projects.
First thing we all think of is how can we be safe and secure and responsible?
My field of expertise is in biosafety, so this is the most obvious great place to be.
We believe that responsibility should be at the heart of innovation. And all of you iGEMers are a vital part of this.
The hope for the AI is for it to become a predictive tool for the design of organisms and enzymes.
There is a lot of different companies that are really showing that AI can support pathologists, especially in oncology.
We aim to empower the next generation of biofounders. 15 of our best teams out of 88 have come to Paris to pitch at the innovation stage.
You get people who have this experience, this grit, this drive, working together in a very constrained timeline to achieve a very hard objective as a team. This is not something you get the chance to experience in academia.
If we're talking about things like flourishing and biodiversity loss and safety and security and the biotic future, and we're talking about it like we're talking about it today and it's suddenly the year 2032, that'll be too late. Don't wait. Now is the time to advance the biotic future we wish for.